grown lungs and the clumsiest of feet, they have become the first backboned animals to leave the sea.
I think he was waiting to get into the land.
But they couldn't leave it altogether, for they still had to return to the water to lay their eggs and to be born in, as the fishes before them. Insects too appeared about this time, and some grew to be giant, like this 2.5-foot dragonfly preserved for us as a fossil. Ferns, equisetums, and mosses are still plentiful in the world today, but not the giants of the Paleozoic age. They toppled into the swamps, and with the ages, turned into peat and coal, which are their remains.
Yes, definitely. I remember being driven years ago by a person, it was around Burnt Island or something, I can't remember why. But she was driving and she was coming up the road and there was a lorry coming in the opposite direction. And it was, there were cars parked on the other side of the road, so the lorry was over halfway in early. And she's driving towards it and all I'm thinking is, yeah, you're about to get sideswiped. Like, there's going to be a black head on crash here. And I reached across and just took over the wheel and I moved it so she bumped up on the curb.
And these thick skinned reptiles whose eggs could hatch on dry land were branching out, producing clumsy, bow-legged varieties who lived off plants. And others who were savage and agile flesh eaters. Lush forests had given way to smaller, tougher plants, and the reign of the amphibian was over.